You're listening to Morning Meditation with Reverend Tashi Campbell. Thank you so much for subscribing to the YouTube channel and for joining me via podcast. Your listenership means so much to me. And we are exactly 1 week away from my first anniversary of ministry via this medium. And I want to thank you so much for your support and for sharing with your friends and your family. Indeed, God has been faithful. God has been gracious. And I look forward to many, many, many more years to come. God bless you. Stay tuned as this morning's episode of Morning Meditation is coming up in a few minutes. Well, actually, a few seconds. I've been thinking about friendships, how precious and awesome true friendships are. If you have friends, like good friends, even a best friend, you know what I'm talking about. I find it interesting that there are so many people who celebrate not having any friends at all. I know of married women who have no friendships outside of their spouse. In my mind, that's not recommended. I know that for some persons this will be hard to receive, but friendships are important and the formation of good friendships will be worth it in the end. My friends, we were not meant to be alone. That's why God designed relationships, not just of the marital and familial kind, but friendships as well. Friendships provide us with multifaceted support, love, and even entertainment. Let's take a look at some friendships in the Bible and see what traits we can garner from them to look at what do real, true friendships look like. First up, David and Jonathan. When we look at the friendship that David and Jonathan shared, we see that there were three elements. And actually, these three traits have been affirmed by psychologists that they are essential for friendships. Those three traits are love, loyalty, and emotional openness. Where we see between David and Jonathan, they shared that kind of openness with each other, expressing how they feel. They were loyal to each other. And of course, they loved. The Bible says that Jonathan loved David as he loved his own soul. So David and Jonathan, we see three elements: love, loyalty, and emotional openness. And then secondly, we look at Moses and Aaron. The partnership that they shared would be that was a great example of how two friends can work together to accomplish something great. And you know what? God sometimes blesses us with friends who help us achieve more than we could ever achieve if we were doing it alone. And that's the example we see with Moses and Aaron. Then thirdly, there is Elijah and Elisha. The friendship that they shared underscored the importance of purposeful choosing of friends. You know, Elisha knew that Elijah would be a great guide for him. And my encouragement and the example that we see with this friendship between Elijah and Elisha is that we should choose friends who are wise, choose friends who are holy, who are righteous, who are passionate about what they do. Because after all, we tend to become like the people we hang out with. Isn't that true? Yeah, we do. We tend to do that. And then finally, we see Ruth and Naomi. Ruth and Naomi show us the value of loyalty, unconditional love, and self-sacrifice. This is what the Bible says in Proverbs 18, verse 24, which is an interesting verse because if you read different versions of the Bible with this particular verse, you get a different sense. Now, I'm reading the New King James Version, and it says, "A man who has friends must himself be friendly, but there is a friend who sticks closer than a brother." And there's another version that says, "If a man who has many friends will soon come to ruin." Or a man who has unreliable friends, that's it. One who has unreliable friends will soon come to ruin. But there is a friend who sticks closer than a brother. Nobody wants unreliable friends. I don't know about you, but I don't want unreliable friends. So my question to you today in this episode of Morning Meditation is, what kind of friend are you? Apart from your familial relationships, is there anyone to whom you are loyal? Anyone to whom you display emotional openness? Is there anyone who you really love as a friend? You see, most people want these things out of a friendship, but many people are not willing to give it, to give of themselves. If you disappear out of their lives tomorrow, they wouldn't care because we have become so selfish and unfriendly that we never reach out to anyone. Can I tell you, maintaining good friendships will take sacrifice, it will take time, it will take effort, and it takes initiative sometimes. But I leave these two things with you. If we become the best friend that we can be, then we would be a blessing to someone else. And secondly, there should be at least one person. This is my recommendation. This is my belief, and I live by this. There should be at least one person, a friend, with whom you can be open and honest without feeling judged or condemned, without having to worry about confidentiality. A friend who is a friend in my humble, esteemed opinion, a friend is anyone around whom we can be our true selves without having to worry about losing the friendship. A friend is anyone around whom we can be our true selves without having to worry about losing that friendship. What kind of friend are you? Well, let's pray. Thank you, Jesus. You are worthy. You are awesome. You are mighty. And there is no one who is like you. We thank you, mighty God, for your word to us today, for this reflection. Lord, there are so many of us, God, who have been hurt by others. And there is just the challenge of finding people in whom we can trust or rely on. And so, Lord God, you know, our experiences have taught us that maybe it has convinced us that maybe it's just better to be alone and not have any friends. But Lord God Almighty, we know that you have created us for friendships, for relationships, because it's not your desire that we go through this life and navigate through our seasons and the vicissitudes of life doing it alone, because it's always good to have friends that we can lean on, that can support us and that can really just be there for us and laugh. But Lord, we know that as humans we have limitations, and we know that circumstances will cause us to not be able to depend on even the persons that we refer to as our best friends all the time. And that's why we need you, Jesus. Lord, your word says, you know, when the Bible says that there is a friend who sticks closer than a brother, we know that that friend is Jesus Christ. For in the end, Lord, at the end of it all, you are the only constancy in our lives. You are loyal. You are faithful. We can always call on you. You are always there. We can always depend on you. And you, Lord Jesus, have called us friends. You say that we are no longer servants, but we are friends. You are mindful of us. And so you have extended your love to us. While we were yet sinners, you died for us. You have initiated the friendship. You have pursued us. You love us unconditionally. We can be open and honest in your presence. We can come and talk with you about everything and anything. We can be ourselves around you and not feel as if the friendship is threatened, because you are God and you're perfect. So Lord, I pray that you will teach us how to be friendly towards others, how to be a friend towards others. I pray that you will give us wisdom and revelation, mighty God, to really just, you know, show us who we are to choose as friends, in the same way that the friendship that Elijah and Elisha shared was a purposeful choosing of the friendship. Help us to be purposeful in our choosing as well. Bring into our lives people with whom we can join forces and accomplish greatness, Lord, even more than we would if we were alone, just like Moses and Aaron. Lord, bring people into our lives who will show us the value of loyalty, unconditional love, and self-sacrifice, as Ruth and Naomi did. Help us to be selfless as we show ourselves to be friendly to others. Guard our hearts, mighty God, as we depend on you. And we thank you so much. We commit all our relationships to you, all our friendships to you, and we ask you to have your own way. In Jesus' name we pray. Can you say amen? Amen.